Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In this video, we are discussing about padding, dimensions and layouts. In the last video, we are discussing about borders, outline and margin. The three concepts are discussed in the previous video. In this video, we are learning padding, dimensions and layouts. After that, we will explain it practically. So, in the last video, we are discussing border, outline and margin. Now we are discussing padding, dimensions and layout. Okay. So, padding. The CSS padding properties define the white space between the element content and the element border. So, let us assume this is the content space and this is the border space. This space is defined as padding. Okay, this is border. This is the content. So in between the space, this space is called padding. Okay, so the white space between the element content and the element border. Okay, the padding clears an area around the content inside the border of an element. Padding individual sites. CSS has properties for specifying the padding for each of an element. Padding top, padding right, padding bottom and padding left. All the padding properties can have the following values. Length specifies a padding in px, pixels, pt, point, cm, centimeters, etc. Otherwise, percentage specifies a padding in percentage of the width of the containing element. Inherit specifies that the padding should be inherited from the parent element. So let us take an example. The border is 1px and solid and red, means the entire thing is this. Background color yellow, so the background color of the text is yellow. Now padding top is 50, padding right is 30, padding bottom is 50 and padding left is 80. So according to this space, it gives the measurement. Okay, so if you take only one p1, it will not give reflection. If you take two or three, definitely you can understand the difference. Okay, so the next is dimensions. The CSS dimension properties allow you to control the height and width of an element. Setting height and width. The height and width properties are used to set the height and width of an element. Width is 500px and height is 100px. And the border is, we are giving 3px solid and some color will be defined. Okay. Setting maximum width means it is stretchable up to the text. But maximum of 500px. After it reaches the destination end of the 500px, again the text will move into second line. Like this, it will continue. Okay, so that is called maximum width. Height is same, then meaning process here. Okay, while we are discussing practically, you can understand very clearly based on the text itself. Now, the important part is layout, the display. Okay, so the display property is the most important CSS property for controlling layout. The display property specifies if / how an element is displayed. Every HTML element has a default display value depending on what type of element it is. The default display value for most elements is block or inline. Block level element. A block level element always starts on a new line and it takes up the full width available. Stretches out to the left and right as far as it can. इनलाइन एलिमेंट्स, एन इनलाइन एलिमेंट डज नॉट स्टार्ट ऑन ए न्यू लाइन एंड ओनली टेक्स अप एज मच विथ एज नेसेसरी. नेक्स्ट डिस्प्ले. डिस्प्ले नन इज कॉमनली यूज विथ जावास्क्रिप्ट टू हाइड एंड शो एलिमेंट्स विदाउट डिलीटिंग एंड रिक्रिएटिंग दैम. द स्क्रिप्ट एलिमेंट यूज डिस्प्ले नन एज इट्स डिफॉल्ट. नाउ आई एम टेकिंग फ्यू एग्जाम्पल्स हियर. स्पैम डिस्प्ले ब्लॉक विजिबिलिटी H1 डॉट हिडन विजिबिलिटी इज हिडन. LI डिस्प्ले इन लाइन H1 डॉट हिडन नन. सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट थिंग्स वी आर यूजिंग इट इन प्रैक्टिकली. आई विल एक्सप्लेन हाउ बेस्ट इट इज यूज. नेक्स्ट लेआउट पोजिशन. द पोजिशन प्रॉपर्टी. द पोजिशन प्रॉपर्टी स्पेसिफाइज द टाइप्स ऑफ पोजिशनिंग मेथड यूज फॉर एन एलिमेंट. देर आर फोर डिफरेंट पोजिशन वैल्यूज. वन इज स्टैटिक, रिलेटिव, फिक्स एंड एब्सोल्यूट. एलिमेंट्स आर देन पोजिशन यूजिंग द टॉप, बॉटम, लेफ्ट एंड राइट प्रॉपर्टीज. ओके. डिव रिलेटिव. द पोजिशन इज रिलेटिव. विथ इज 400 एंड हाइट इज 200 एंड बॉर्डर 3x पेज सॉलिड एंड सम कलर विल बी डिफाइंड. सिमिलरली I am using absolute. The position is absolute. Top is equal to 80, right is equal to 0, width is equal to 200 and height is equal to 100 and border will be specified. So according to that, the layouts are created. Okay, it gives more reflection to the property. Okay, so in this video we learned about one is padding. It is most important. Why? Because more than one dimensions are divisions are putting in a single row with the help of padding. The second one is dimensions, means the width and heights are specifications are mentioned in the dimensions tab. And finally layout. The layouts are very little bit difficult but different and more helpful. Why? Because some of the layouts are invisible or visible or display or non-displaying, block or non-block, different skeletons are provided. At the same time, we are also positioning something for layouts that are static, relative, fixed and absolute. Okay, so we need to, in the next video, we need to learn these things in a practically. Okay, so the next two videos are nothing but the practical things of CSS border, CSS margin, CSS outline, next padding, dimension and layout. These two six things are explained in the next part. After that we are also discussing about images concept, and that images concept is most helpful thing in your journey. Okay. Thank you.